What you just saw was a sneak peek into some of the rigorous preparation that goes into each episode. Today's guest is Joanne Kelly. She's an instructor at Red River College, and she's got a great story. Take a look.
I graduated with my honors in English, and I'd been working at a bank part-time, and I was married at the time, and my husband needed the financial support to finish his school, so I worked full-time at the bank. And no offense to anybody who is a bank teller for a career, but it was a slow, soul-sucking death. My husband left me. Yay! So I was free, I could do what I wanted. So I actually, at that point, I thought I was 25, and I thought, oh my God, I am so old. I've given up my youth, and what am I going to do now? Which is ridiculous, but at the time, I truly did think. So I went to the library. I took out every single college catalog from across Canada and went through them to see what stood out. And I saw a journalism program. And it was like that light bulb of, oh, that's what I always wanted to do. So there was a program in Vancouver, a one-year program for people with degrees, Langara, and it was focused on print. So I applied, and I got put on a wait list. And I understand why, because my portfolio was my honors thesis on Chaucer, which, when I think about it now, I'm quite embarrassed about that. I didn't have any experience. So I was on a wait list, which I assumed meant I wouldn't get in. And at that time, the bank offered me a management training program. And I tucked my soul away into a little envelope and put it aside and said, okay, I got to do it. So the day that I accepted, or I was going to accept, the college phoned and I was in. Journalism school was life-changing. I was where I was supposed to be, and it felt fabulous. My school was print. The focus was on print, but we did have one tiny little broadcast section, one edit suite, one camera that we all booked out, and we got to do, I think I did two stories.
In 1970, there were only 7 mute swans on Lake Cowichan. Today, there's more than 200. And those swans have been causing problems.
My broadcast instructor was Mac Reimel, an old CBC guy, and I loved him. And I've learned, I still to this day have things that he told me that I use in class. He suggested when I graduated, we didn't have work placements. But he suggested there was a brand new TV. CTV was opening up a brand new station in Vancouver. They were still under construction. It was summertime. He said, just show up. So I did. I showed up every day, and I was going to the hardware store to get things. I was going to get coffee. They let me go on air a couple of times, just doing little stories. But mostly I was doing research for other reporters. And one time they let me wear a little hidden camera in a really god-awful sweater. To do an investigative piece, and they needed someone that nobody would recognize, right? So I got to do that. So I didn't know where this was going. I knew eventually if I stayed this route, I'd be a producer maybe, or maybe one day they'd let me be report. And I came in, I went out to do a pre-interview for one of the reporters, and I came back, and the assignment editor said, I have a letter for you. And he gave me a letter, and I opened it up, and he had written the most amazing reference letter. And I was like, thank you so much. I was going to ask for that. I knew it was time to start looking, but thank you. And he said, well, you're going to be using it. We got a phone call from CKY5 in Winnipeg. So they hired me. See, Winnipeg hired me on the spot, because just based on that recommendation. So packed up and came to Winnipeg, and loved it. I reported Wednesday, Thursday, Fridays, and then I produced the evening cast on the weekends. And tonight I'll have a full story reaction from the owners, the workers, and the fire department tonight on CKY5 News at 6. Back to you, Barb. I ended up wanting to go back to Vancouver, so I took a job in communications. It was awful, and it turned out within 2 weeks of starting in that job, it turned out that they were just a front for the mafia, money laundering front. And I wondered why I just showed up every day, and they're like, don't worry, we'll get you work. And I just sat at a desk every day and did nothing and got paid for it. So came into work one day and they said, Don't use the phones. We think they're bugged. And by the way, you're laid off. So total panic, because here I am. I was 31 at this point, and I'd given up a fabulous job for this, and now I had nothing. So I called my old assignment editor, the one who got me the job in Winnipeg, and he was back at a different TV station, the biggest one in North America, and he said, you can start tomorrow. Come on in. So I came back to Winnipeg, and I produced The Noon for a couple more years until... It's funny how you put things out in the universe. I was getting slightly bored, but I didn't want to make the same mistake in my last time of leaving a job that I liked. But I'd been out for dinner with some friends, and a friend of a friend of a friend was there who worked at Shaw. She was the government liaison for Shaw Cable. And I had mentioned over dinner that I was looking for something new. So she remembered that about a year later when they were looking to create a community channel, a community show, and they were looking for a host producer. So they called me and hired me. And for the next couple of years, I helped build an amazing team of reporters and shooter editors, and we had the most fabulous run.
There's probably another 2 weeks. Go to our giant Penny at Portage Place. Go to the Walmart. You'll see my picture on the front. I've got my wings on there.
Things started to change at Shaw. I wasn't happy there. So again, had dropped a few hints to people that I was looking, and Steve, who was the broadcast journalism instructor, was ready to retire, and he knew I was looking. So he called me, and we met and talked, and he gave me a lot of advice. I applied for the job and got it. I feel like I'm absolutely, everything in my life has led me to this. This is where I'm supposed to be.
As always, find our full interview below in the podcast. Next week is going to be part two of my interview with Joanne Kelly, where she talks about her favorite parts of being a teacher, and also she speaks to those of you who don't really know what you want to do in your career. Don't miss it. Today on the book club, the fire starter sessions with Danielle Laporte. This book is all about finding your own definition of success, because guess what? It's not always about the money. There's a lot more to fulfillment and creating a meaningful career than money. And this book kind of helps you define what you want and what you need to feel good in your job.
I love seeing, you can actually see a young person's mind get bigger, see their brain grow. You can see it.